Hello everyone, I am Saideh and welcome back to my channel Saideh Korean. Today's related to order the screen recording of features comparison between the iQOO 7 versus Realme X1 Max versus MI11X device. So a lot of users did ask me this kind of question that which phone is best for the screen recording, what are the features MI11X has, what are the features iQOO 7 has. So I thought of making all the videos together in one single video, so which might be useful for a lot of other users as well. So let's see friends how well these different UIs are treating the screen recording in what kind of manner. That is what I'm going to test in this video. So first let's start with the iQOO 7 device. So iQOO 7 device which has got the FunTouch UI. So let's start exploring the option by going into the screen recording. You can actually find in the notification toggle here. By long pressing on that option, you'll get all these kind of options as you can see friends. So first thing is pretty clear, you can actually record the sound. So system audio or microphone audio, or maybe the system audio and the microphone audio, as you can see. It's pretty clear and straightforward. You can select three different options, and even none as well you can also select. That's pretty good to record the system and microphone sound at same time. That's really great. And next is the picture quality. In the picture quality, you don't get a representation like numbers. Like I mean 1080, 720 and 480. You need to understand by looking at this contest. So high means 1080, medium means 720 and the low means 480. This kind of resolutions, that is what they spoke. So even there's an option for the disabling the notification while recording option as well. As you can see, there's no option to select the frame rates or what kind of frame rates you want. You cannot select that because it's kind of predetermined. Like for example, if the game supports 60 FPS, it will try to record at 60 FPS. If the game supports 30, it will try to record it. It's like dynamic refresh rate. That is what the screen recording does in the iQOO 7 device. And next one to explore is the Realme X1 Max. Let's see how well the Realme UI is kind of treating in terms of the screen recording. That is what I'm going to test in this video. Let me try to drag the same thing. And this is the screen recording, the Realme X1 Max is how the Realme UI is designed. So you do get the first option is recording system sound and recording the microphone sound. You can have both at same time or only single at same time. As you can see, you can have that kind of option. That's a good thing to have. And next is the video resolution. So if you try to tap on the video resolution, now it will take you to the next page where you can actually select what kind of bitrate you want. That's a really very good customization friends, because you should know the screen recording will definitely consume a lot of data. So you should be aware of how much data is utilizing as well. That's a really good thing to test it. So first you do have the 1080. You can actually choose the predetermined values as well if you don't want to select, but still try to go to the custom and try to select the 1080, and then you can actually change the bitrate how much you want. So in this way, you can actually decrease and increase the size of the screen recording. That's a very good useful feature which I did find in the Realme X1 Max when compared with the iQOO 7 device. So let's move to the next option, which is a frame rates. That's a really good thing. So 30, 24 and 15. And there's a dynamic which also based upon the applications and current recording. So if the game plays at 60 FPS, then obviously all the games, most of the games are 60 only. It will try to record at 60 FPS as well. So in case if you want me to include the recording of this phone, so make sure to comment below. I'll try to upload another video on that particular topic. So in this way, you'll be able to understand. But this video is basically focused only on exploring the features. So what type of UI has got what type of features in the screen recording. And next is video coding format as well. That's a really good thing. So for smaller video sizes and for best compatibility, we do have this kind of options. That's really great. And front camera, that's wonderful friends. You can actually even see the front camera as well while recording the screen. That's fantastic. So which is not present in the by default in the iQOO 7 device. And next is show touch options. As you can see, that's also another good advantage. So overall, we do have a lot of customization in the Realme UI. We do know the Realme UI is established a lot, MIUI and the Realme UI. That is the reason they do have really great customizable option. So maybe the FunTouch UI is latest UI only. So still it needs some time to get this kind of level. So now let's move to the next phone, which is the MI11X device in terms of the screen recording customization in the MI11X. So I'm trying to use the screen recording version, which is a 1.9.7 version. I'm trying to show you the version itself. So because I'll try to explain you why. So as you can see friends, right now we do have the first option, which is a resolution. That's great. And you can actually select 720, 480 or in this way. And next is the video quality, 100 Mbps and 50 bitrate and maybe 32 and 24 and 16. So you cannot get less than that. That's another thing you should notice, as you can see. So I'm trying to use this version, which is 1.9.7 only friends. So in case if you see different options, you can definitely comment below. And next is a sound. So mic sound or system sound, that's it. So you cannot use both at same time. That's also another disadvantage. But in these two phones, you can actually use system sound and microphone sound at same time in these two phones, but not in the MI11X device. That's one thing to note down. And next is fixed frame rates. You can see the fixed frame rates. So you can actually fix the, you can actually select the frame rate how you want, and you can actually fix that. So it won't change. That's a really fantastic thing. And in this version, we do have the 90 FPS recording as well. I'll try to do the 90 FPS recording, and I'll try to post online how it looks. So make sure to stay tuned for that video in case if you are interested. And next is a lock screen to end. There's an option that, and a show touches option. That's fantastic. So we do have that option in the MIUI as well. So visualize the navigation bar buttons. So it's a show prompts when pressing the power button, back button. That's good. Okay. That's also another advantage, friends, in this MIUI. And go back to the screen recording open after the, when you stop recording. That's also a thing. So you do a lot of customization, but the main customization which I did like in the bitrate, where you can actually control how much you want the bitrate of the resolution as well, everything. You can even come to one and each and every category. I did like this kind of feature. So mainly to save a lot of data, it will be really helpful for a lot of other users as well. And showing front camera is also another key highlight point in the Realme UI. So these are the key highlight points, and the key highlight point in the IQ7 device at this moment, I did not find any key highlight point because everything is quite same when compared with other phones. So there's nothing much different happening in this phone. So in the MI11X device, the different is the fixed frame rates. That's a kind of different option. And apart from that, there's nothing much different. So we learn navigation bar buttons and getting 90 FPS. So if you use this APK screen recording of 1.9.7, in case if you want, I can definitely make another video on that particular topic as well. And now let's move to the screen recording floating bar, how it looks. So in the IQ7 device, this is how the floating bar looks. As you can see, friends, you can actually press on that one and you can pause the recording. So if you don't want to continue the recording, you can actually pause and you can actually continue again whenever you are comfortable. For example, if you are playing the Battlegrounds mobile game, so definitely if you are trying to join the match, you don't want to waste that kind of time and save some data, you can definitely pause, and when you are in the match exactly, and then you can actually start. It's a really good advantage, friends, which is really useful for a lot of other users. Instead of making multiple videos and combining them together, in this way you can actually utilize. That's a fantastic option, and which is a floating in this way, as you can see. And now let's move to the next is the Realme. So let's see Realme how it's handling the floating bar. So we do get the recording option and settings option and the into option. So three options you are getting. Right now let's select on the recording. And as soon as you select the recording, you can actually get this pause option enabled, as you can see. So even the Realme also allows you to pause the screen recording. That's fantastic. That is what I did like in terms of the screen recording. That's excellent. Now let's see what the MI is using in terms of pausing. So it's a small floating. As you can see, the floating recording is happening here. I think you cannot keep exactly in the middle. Either you can keep only at the corners. That's the one thing. But in other two smartphones, you can actually keep wherever you want. I think wherever, no, even the Realme UI is not allowing. Only in the top or bottom directions only you can actually keep, I think. But in the IQ UI, it's allowing anywhere you can place the floating bar. That's the one thing which I thought of just mentioning to you. So MI, you cannot keep even on the top MIUI. When you try to pause, that's it. There is no option to pause in the MIUI at this moment. That's the one thing which is definitely lacking in this phone. So if it has got the pausing, then that would be really great to have this kind of extra benefit to experience, friends. That is what my request is. So thank you for watching this video, friends. This is a quick comparison between all the UIs, so which will be might be useful for few of the users in case if they are interested in this kind of content. So thank you for watching, and see you in the next video, friends. Until then, stay tuned for more updates. Bye.